Shri Bhagavad Gita, Chapter 11, The Universal Form. In this chapter, Lord Krishna shows Arjuna his real form. Arjuna said, "By my hearing the instructions you have kindly given me about these confidential spiritual subjects, my illusion has now been dispelled. O lotus-eyed one, I have heard from you in detail about the appearance and disappearance of every living entity and have realized your inexhaustible glories. O greatest of all personalities, O supreme form, though I see you here before me in your actual position, as you have described yourself, I wish to see how you have entered into this cosmic manifestation. I want to see that form of yours. If you think I am able to behold your cosmic form, O my Lord, O Master of all mystic power, then kindly show me that unlimited universal self." The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, "My dear Arjun, O son of Parth, see now my opulences, hundreds of thousands of varied divine and multicolored forms. O best of the Bharatas, see here the different manifestations of the Adityas, Vasus, Rudras, Ashwini, Kumaras, and all the other demigods. Behold the many wonderful things which no one has ever seen or heard of before. O Arjun, whatever you wish to see, behold at once in this body of mine. This universal form can show you whatever you now desire to see and whatever you may want to see in the future. Everything moving and unmoving is here completely in one place. But you cannot see me with your present eyes. Therefore, I give you divine eyes. Behold me, my mystic opulence." Sanjay said, "O King, having spoken thus, the Supreme Lord of all mystic power, the Personality of Godhead displayed his universal form to Arjuna. Arjuna saw in that universal form unlimited mouths, unlimited eyes, unlimited wonderful visions. The form was decorated with many celestial ornaments and bore many divine appraised weapons. He wore celestial garlands and garments, and many divine scents were smeared over his body. All was wondrous, brilliant, unlimited, all expanding. If hundreds of thousands of suns were to rise at once into the sky, their radiance might resemble the effulgence of the Supreme Person in that universal form. All that time, Arjuna could see in the universal form of the Lord the unlimited expansions of the universe, situated in one place, although divided into many, many thousands. Then, bewildered and astonished, his hair standing on end, Arjuna bowed his head to offer obeisance and with folded hands began to pray to the Supreme Lord. Arjuna said, "My Lord, Lord Krishna, I see assembled in your body all the demigods and various other living entities. I see Brahma sitting on the lotus flower, as well as Lord Shiva and all the sages and divine serpents. O Lord of the universe, O universal form, I see in your body many, many arms, bellies, mouths and eyes, expanding everywhere without limit. I see in you no end, no middle and no beginning. Your form is difficult to see because of its glaring effulgence, spreading on all sides, like blazing fire on the immeasurable radiance of the sun. Yet I see this glowing form everywhere, adorned with various crowns, clubs and discs. You are the supreme primal objective. You are the ultimate resting place of all the universe. You are inexhaustible and you are the oldest. You are the maintainer of the eternal religion, the Personality of Godhead. This is my opinion. You are without origin, middle or end. Your glory is unlimited. You have numberless arms and the sun and the moon are your eyes. I see you with blazing fire coming forth from your mouth, burning this entire universe by your own radiance. Although you are one, you spread throughout the sky and the planets and all space between. O great one, seeing this wondrous and terrible form, all the planetary system are perturbed. All the hosts of demigods are surrendering before you and entering into you. Some of them, very much afraid, are offering prayers with folded hands. Hosts of great sages and perfected beings crying, all peace, are praying to you by singing the Vedic hymns. All the various manifestations of Lord Shiva, the Adityas, the Vasus, the Sadhyas, the Vivishdevas, the two Asvis, the Marutas, the forefathers, the Gandharvas, the Yakshas, the Asuras, the perfected demigods are beholding you in wonder. O mighty armed one, all the planets with the demigods are disturbed at seeing your great form with its many faces, eyes, arms, thighs, legs and bellies and your many terrible teeth. And as they are disturbed, so am I. O all-pervading Vishnu, seeing you with your many radiant colors touching the sky, your gaping mouths and your great glowing eyes, my mind is perturbed by fear. I can no longer maintain my steadiness or equilibrium of my mind. O Lord of Lords, O Refuge of the Worlds, please be gracious to me. I cannot keep my balance seeing thus your blazing death-like faces and awful teeth in all directions. I am bewildered. All the sons of Dhritarashtra, along with their allied kings, and Bhishma, Drona, Karna, and our chief soldiers, are also rushing into your fearful mouth, and some I see trapped with heads smashed between your teeth. As the many waves of the rivers flow into the ocean, so do all these great warriors enter in blazing into your mouths. I see all people rushing full speed into your mouths as moths dash to destruction in a blazing fire. O Vishnu, I see you devouring all people from all sides with your flaming mouths, covering all the universe with your effulgence. You are manifest with terrible scorching rays. O Lord of Lords, no so fierce of form, please tell me who you are. I offer my obeisance unto you. Please be gracious to me. You are the primal Lord. I want to know about you, for I do not know what your mission is. The Supreme Personality of God had said, time, I am the great destroyer of the worlds, and I have come here to destroy all people, with the exception of you, the Pandavas. All the soldiers here on both sides will be slain. Therefore, get up, prepare to fight and win glory. Conquer your enemies and enjoy a flourishing kingdom. They are already put to death by my arrangements. And you, O Savyasi, can be but an instrument in the fight. Drona, Bhishma, Jayadratha, Karna and all the other great warriors have already been destroyed by me. Therefore, kill them and do not be disturbed. Simply fight and you will vanquish your enemies in battle. Sanjay said to Dhritarashtra, O King, after hearing these words from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the trembling Arjun offered obeisance and with folded hands again and again, he fearfully spoke to Lord Krishna in a faltering voice as follows. Arjun said, O Master of the senses, the world becomes joyful upon hearing your name, and thus everyone becomes attached to you. Although the perfected beings offer you their respectful homage, the demons are afraid and they flee here and there. All this is rightly done. O Great One, greater even than Brahma, you are the original creator. Why then should they not offer their respectful obeisances unto you, O Limitless One, God of Gods, Refuge of the Universe? You are the invincible source, the cause of all causes, transcendental to this material manifestation. You are the original personality of Godhead, the oldest, the ultimate sanctuary of this manifested cosmic world. You are the knower of everything and you are all that is knowable. You are the supreme refuge above the material modes. O Limitless Form, this whole cosmic manifestation is pervaded by you. Thinking of you as my friend, I have rashly addressed you, O Krishna, O Yadavas, O my friend, not knowing your glories. Please forgive whatever I may have done in madness or in love. I have dishonored you many times. Jesting as we relaxed, lay on the same bed, or sat or ate together, sometimes alone and sometimes in front of my many friends. O infallible one, please excuse me for all these offenses. You are the father of this complete cosmic manifestation of the moving of the unmoving, of the non-moving. You are its worshipable chief, the supreme spiritual master. No one is equal to you, nor can anyone be one with you. How then could there be anyone greater than you within the three worlds, O Lord of immeasurable power? You are the supreme Lord to be worshipped by every living being. Thus I fall down to offer you my respectful obeisances and ask your mercy. As a father tolerates the impudence of his son, a friend the impertinence of a friend, or a wife the familiarity of a partner, please tolerate the wrongs I may have done to you. After seeing this universal form, which I have never seen before, I am gladdened, but at the same time my mind is disturbed with fear. Therefore, please bestow your grace upon me and reveal again your form as the personality of Godhead, O Lord of Lords, O abode of the universe. O universal form, O thousands-armed Lord, I wish to see you in your four-armed form and helmeted head, with helmeted head and with club, wheel, conch, the lotus flower in your hands. I long to see you in that form. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, my dear Arjun, happily here I have shown you my eternal potency, this supreme universal form within the material world. No one before you has ever seen this primal form, unlimited and full of clearing effulgences. O best of the Kuru warriors, no one before you has ever seen this universal form of mine, for neither by studying the Vedas, nor by performing sacrifices, nor by charity, nor by pious activities, nor by severe penances can I be seen in this form in the material world. You have been perturbed and bewildered by seeing this horrible feature of mine. Now let it be finished. My devotee, be free again from all disturbances. With a peaceful mind, you can now see the form you desire. Sanjay said to Dhritarashtra, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, having spoken thus to Arjun, displayed his real four-armed form and at last showed his two-armed form, thus encouraging the fearful Arjun. When Arjun thus saw Krishna in his original form, he said, O Janardana, seeing this human-like form so very beautiful, I am now composed in mind and I am restored to my original nature. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, my dear Arjun, this form of mine you are now seeing is very difficult to behold. Even the demigods are ever seeking the opportunity to see this form, which is so dear. The forms you are seeing with your transcendental eyes cannot be understood simply by studying the Vedas, nor by undergoing serious penances, nor by charity, nor by worship. It is not by these means that one can see me as I am. My dear Arjun, only by undivided devotional service can I be understood as I am, standing before you, and can thus be seen directly. Only in this way can you enter into the mysteries of my understanding. My dear Arjun, he who engages in my pure devotional service, free from the contamination of fruitive activities and mental speculation, he who works for me, he who makes me the supreme goal of his life, and who is friendly to every living being, He certainly comes to me. This ends chapter 11 of Shri Bhagavad Gita, the universal form. I request you to kindly subscribe, comment, and give your suggestions so that I can improve for my future videos.